Obviously, Russia has been a principal antagonist of the NATO allies, even if in different ways with different countries. Their cyber capabilities are serious. The willingness of the Russians to use it is serious. Does NATO have the correct posture today to respond effectively to a Russia that doesn't seem very deterred in a lot of their activities, especially in their own near abroad, but also their willingness to intervene in the sovereignty of NATO allies?
So we have, over the last years, since 2014, implemented the biggest reinforcement of our collective defense in a generation. With combat ready battle groups in the eastern part of the alliance, the Baltic countries and Poland, for the first time in our history. With a significantly increased readiness of our forces, with a new Atlantic command, with more defense spending. For the first time in many years, actually, allies are investing more in defense. And all of this is very much triggered by Russia's behavior since 2014. The illegal annexation of Crimea, the continued destabilization of eastern Ukraine, the cyber attacks we have seen, the Russian presence in Syria, and also the way they have tried to interfere in domestic political processes in the United States, in Germany, in many other countries. So all of this has led to the strongest reinforcement of our collective defense of NATO for many, many years. It has also led to that we are now doing more, for instance, when it comes to cyber defense. And also addressing this fact that there's a more blurred line between peace and conflict. And cyber is one example of that. So we have stated clearly that a cyber attack can trigger Article 5, as it can trigger our collective defense clause. We have established cyber as a military domain alongside air, sea, and land. Cyber is now an independent military domain. And we conduct, you know, the most advanced, the biggest cyber exercises in the world to help to improve the way we protect our own networks, the NATO networks, but also how allies can protect their networks and increase the awareness of risks related to cyber attacks.
Do you think that cyber attacks are the principal concern that NATO allies are going to have with the Russians over the coming, as we think about 2030? Is that the area that the most work needs to be done?
At least it is one of the important areas where we need to make sure that we are up to the challenge, that we are modernizing and strengthening our capabilities. But again, I'm a bit afraid of pointing at one area, because I think one of the challenges we face today is that we have so many different challenges at the same time. We have a more brutal form of terrorism with ISIS. We have Russia using military means against Ukraine, grabbing a part of another country, Crimea. And then we have cyber, but for instance, also disinformation. I think that it's all of this together that makes it so complex and so hard to predict what will be the next main cause for a crisis. But that's the reason why we need to be ready and vigilant and be prepared for the unforeseen. My message on that is that we need to counter that with facts, and we share information. We help allies when encountering disinformation campaigns when we see that from Russia, from others. But the main way to counter disinformation is to make sure that we have strong, resilient, healthy societies, because they are less vulnerable for disinformation. And perhaps the most important thing is to have a free and independent press, which is checking their sources, asking the difficult questions, and makes us all less vulnerable for disinformation campaigns.